The interesting thing about evolution is that it's an incredibly powerful way of figuring out which pieces of the DNA are important. The Zoonomia Project is a project that we started a number of years ago now to sequence the genomes, the DNA, of hundreds of different mammalian species, and then compare all of those genomes to each other across all of placental mammal evolution, so about 100 million years of evolution. My name is Elinor Karlsson, and my lab studies how we can use evolution, so the history of how species evolved, as a way to understand how DNA works.
By studying the genomes of other species, we can learn a lot about both them and the human genome. My name is Kerstin Lindblad-Toh. My lab focuses on comparative genomics, where we look at the genomes of mammals and other species to understand genome evolution and human disease better.
We can look at this kind of comparison of these hundreds of different mammals and identify places in the DNA with two different and very distinctive patterns. The first is that we see a position that doesn't have any changes in it at all. That suggests that every time that position in the DNA has changed, those animals didn't survive and didn't have any descendants. So that suggests that whatever that position is doing, it's doing something very important.
It's also important to look at the positions that are changing quickly because they are often the ones that will allow species to evolve and adapt to their unique environments. For human disease, there's been a lot of association studies trying to identify regions of the genome that underlie disease. But often there's a large number of variants there, and it's very hard to understand which variant or mutation is actually underlying the disease. The possibility of this data is really large in terms of trying to understand the biology of human disease.
We started by going back and working with a lot of other scientists to get samples from species that hadn't been sequenced before, and started this process of lining up all of the DNA.
We are looking at a total of 240 mammals.
We wanted to be able to identify which individual positions in the genome were unusually conserved, meaning that they hadn't changed across all of mammalian evolution. And basically, the more species you have, the more power you have to detect those single base changes. And over half of these samples actually ended up coming from a place called the Frozen Zoo, which is run by the San Diego Wildlife Alliance. One thing that we were very aware of throughout the whole project is that the reason why it works is because we had this huge diversity of mammals in there. For species that we don't know a whole lot about, by studying their genomes, we can actually start to get an idea of whether they're at risk of going extinct or not.
What excites me the most about the project is that it's so diverse, but more specifically also that it will allow us to look at human disease associated regions and really help understand the biology of disease, because I think fundamentally that's really important for generating new treatment options for patients.
One of the things that I'm really looking forward to in the future is to see what other people do with this data set. With the group of papers that we're publishing now, we're only really scratching the surface of the different types of questions you can ask. That's the way that science actually moves forward, is by getting as many different people to think about a problem as we can.